Hey, stop. Whoa. Hey. What? You gotta stop. Watch. Watch what we do. Now, you've probably clicked on this thingy because you want to improve your CTR, your click-through rate, don't you, on Instagram or whatever. So, hold your horses just 1 second. Before you do that, why don't you have a little look at our website, TheAgency.io, and then, you know, see, they've got some good social media marketing stuff going on there, as well as loads of other so have a little look on there. Right, we'll get back into it. So, obviously, you want to improve your click-through rate, but what is that? Thanks for asking. Your click-through rate is when you land onto the explore page on Instagram. There's a load of crap on there, isn't there? There's so much stuff, so much noise, and you get a little bit lost in it. But how can you provoke someone to click on your post in a sea of noise? So obviously Instagram's a business, isn't it? And it wants you to stay on that page as much as possible. And how do you do that? You post as much as you can. And if you, once you get onto the explore page, the more time people spend on yours, the more, you know, the better the algorithm's gonna work out for you. So how do you do that? You've got to make your post on the explore page provoke an emotion. So let's focus on the emotion provoking. It's, my neck hurts from nodding so much, man. I completely agree with you. Exactly, so the emotions that you've got potentially to use, you've got funny things like this. Sad, now you do sad. Very good. Anger, he's doing anger. Fear, nostalgia, hope, anticipation, and trust. He's very good. So to provoke a funny emotion, obviously you can use things like memes that relate to a lot of people, talking about current affairs and things like that, for example. Stupid, funny pictures. You know things that are funny. Like, you laugh at things that are funny. You probably follow a meme page yourself. You can even literally recycle stuff that they've got. Anger, you probably want to steer away from, but things like social injustice, posts about, you know, like recent topics like Black Lives Matter, things like that, or the Katie Hopkins of the world, the people that just go out to just say the worst possible thing they can in order to milk attention. You don't really want to be that type of person, do you? So I'd steer clear of provoking any anger in your posts. Now, provoking nostalgia is quite a popular one. If you want to provoke a little bit of nostalgia, no, there's a decent page, it's called like the 90s or something like that, and it's just all just little memes again of things that you might remember from the 90s. And, you know, things like a picture of a street lamp that's turned on that says, this was my curfew when this came on, you know, or, but you know, Pokemon bouncy balls. And you go, I do remember that, I'm gonna like that, because that provokes a nostalgic reaction in me. That's what your subconscious is saying a little bit, innit? You can also build up things like hope by, you know, inspirational videos. Then you got things like lotteries and things like that. If you're a business and you're in the marketing end of it and you wanna provoke a little bit of hope in someone, give them a chance to feel that they could win something or benefit something for free from you. That's gonna provoke hope, innit? So, you know, lotteries and all those types of things, like, what are they called? No, don't. I'm thinking about it. Interactive posts. And then obviously, once you've got your content done and your post ready to upload, the next thing you need to do is think about your caption. And in your caption, there should always be a question, because you want to provoke as much engagement, as well as provoking as much emotion through the post as possible. You then want to provoke engagement so that it's got a higher chance of climbing up on the old explore page itself, hasn't it? Because if you don't ask a question, no one's going to answer, are they? So if I say to him, you remember those Pokemon balls? Probably going to answer me, isn't he? But if I don't ask it, is he going to say that he remembers the Pokemon balls? Very, very small chance, only if he's a madman. And you've got to essentially remember that likes are great, but the extra engagement, the comments, they're the ones that take you the extra mile. If you're going to take anything away from this video, just remember to provoke an emotion And then, you know, you have to do your hashtags and all that well, but we'll talk about that another time. So we've been Alex.
Well then, it's only
thanks
been
for
brief,
watching.
But
cheers
for watching.
Remember to subscribe.
If you've got any queries, visit us at TheAgency.io. And remember to do what, you know, the YouTube stuff, the subscribe and the liking and the comments. You should comment. We put a lot of work into this to get it so we can get, you know, such... What emotion did we want to provoke in you then? We wanted to make you laugh, didn't we? And I think we just about did. So that's worth a little comment, isn't it? Go on, go for it. Cheers for watching. We're Alex.